your mind still. And I don't wanna go unless you make me
pretty face.
Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Everything Tay. I am back again with another video. Y'all already know the vibes. Today on this video, as y'all can tell by the topic, we're gonna do a Q&A. Okay, I never done a Q&A video. I have done like a get to know more about me video, but I have never did a Q&A video from like people on my social media, people on my groups that I have on YouTube. I never ever did a Q&A video just answering people questions that genuinely really support my channel, or that just interested in supporting my channel, whatever that case may be. Before we get into this video, make sure you give me girls a thumbs up on this video, like, comment, and definitely subscribe at the end of this video. Leave me some feedback because I do love to engage and talk to you guys, answer any of y'all questions. I really love to hear y'all feedback on the things that I do post on my videos. So definitely give me a thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe. Let's go ahead and get into this Q&A, okay? So, like I said, I had asked people to ask me questions of things they would like to see on my channel, or just give me questions of things for my Q&A video or whatever. So, I did gain about 15 questions, which I don't think I'm going to go through all 15, but I'm going to try to go through most of them. And shit, we might go through all 15, who knows? Okay, so let's go ahead and get into it. Okay, so the first question that I got on one of my social medias is, how do I gain the confidence to post myself on social media? Promote myself on social media, I'm sorry. So, honestly, I feel like you are your own biggest supporter. So, I feel like if nobody goes the hardest for you, you should go the hardest for yourself. I feel like you should always promote whatever it is you got going on to the fullest. I don't care if you post 5, 10, 15, 20, 30 times a day and you feel like that you getting on everybody's nerves, or you feel like people are tired of seeing you, go the hardest for yourself. I can't stress that enough. Go the hardest for yourself. You are the reason why your life is going to change, not them, okay?
I always remember
when you post, people are watching you. They might not support you right away or support you at all, but they are definitely watching. And that's what we need them to do, watch, okay? Because you watching me, that's telling me something, okay? Every time I'm posting, you watching me or dropping something on my Instagram or on my YouTube groups or whatever, you comment, you watching, you liking, baby, that's support for me, okay? So always go the hardest for yourself. You are your biggest supporter, okay? Don't ever forget that, period. And Tay told you that, okay? With two eyes. Next question, where am I from? I had said where I was from on my previous video, but like I said, we just getting back up and running. You know, I'm almost a 500 subs. So a lot of y'all is new to my channel. So I can definitely tell y'all where I'm from. I'm from a small city called Lubbock, Texas. It's about 5 hours from Dallas. I'm currently living in Dallas, Texas now, and that was another question, where do you currently stay? So I am currently living in Dallas, Texas, but I'm from a small city called Lubbock, Texas. So you know, I am a country girl, West Texas in the building. So yeah, I've been living in Dallas for about, it's going on 5 years now. It's been like 4.5 years. I'm gonna hit the 5-year mark, but yes, that's where I'm from. Another question is, can you give us any tips or advice for others who are starting a YouTube channel? I definitely can, okay? Tips and advice on others who are starting a YouTube channel is, number one most important thing, and I stress this on myself still to this day, is consistent. You have to be consistent in posting. And that's because that's how you're going to gain all your people coming into your channel. They're going to be like waiting on you to post another video. And a lot of people tell me, like, dang, Tay, when I drop a video, they be right under my video like, girl, where you been? And I just be like, okay, you know what, I have to get more consistent, because I post like 2 or 3 videos and then I just be gone for like a good 3-4 weeks. Like, that's not good. But I feel like if you have a consistent flow on your YouTube channel, that's the more engagement and people that is going to come to your channel and definitely support you. So definitely be consistent. Another big thing that you definitely want to have is great quality videos. You want to have a clean setup, clean background. Quality of your videos needs to be great, okay? If you don't have great quality videos, ain't nobody really gonna watch you like that. And a lot of people tell me on my videos, like, man, your quality is everything. Like, what do you use to record your videos? Girl, my phone. I don't even have a camera, so I'm using my phone. I'm working with what I have. So just work with what you have and be consistent. I just learned this as being a small YouTuber, you know, just getting started. You know, I'm almost to 500 subbies. Just learning. And what I'm going to start doing personally, and I advise you to do it as well. I see a lot of YouTubers doing. When you're recording your videos, just set them up, like, on a schedule. Like how I say I don't post as often as I should is because I'm like, okay, I don't have time to record. Go ahead and record a couple videos and just put them on a schedule. Like, hey, I'm going to post this one at this day at 5, this one at 8. That's my 2 videos for the week. Next week, I already got this video. I'm going to post at 5. I'm going to post this one at 8 as well. That's 4 videos already for 2 weeks. Like, go ahead and have 2, 3, 4 videos already recorded and stuff like that. And then go ahead and just schedule to post them. That way, you don't have to be thinking of, like, what should I do? Or should I, like, you know, just go ahead and do it. That's my thing. So, I've been just recording and then trying to edit as I go. And then, like I'm dropping this video, I have another video back doing in a couple of days. So, that's just something new that I'm getting on to help me be more consistent in YouTube. So, definitely be consistent, have good, clean background, great quality, and just be yourself. Like, how can you be a YouTuber and not yourself? Like, be yourself. This, like, I'm literally talking to a camera to y'all by myself. Like, why are you nervous? I be seeing girls, they be like, man, I be so nervous. I stay yesterday. It's okay. You being yourself. You being naturally you. Don't get on here and be like, okay, so, because I know some YouTubers are like, okay, so, you know, this is, no, be yourself. I'm very authentic. So I think that's how I gain a lot of people to my channel, because I'm me. I'm not trying to be like nobody else, okay, but myself. Get into it. So that's just that on that. And I encourage anyone that want to be a YouTuber, definitely get into YouTubing. People want to see your life. People want to see what you do. People want to see. People are nosy, so they want to see what you do. People love being encouraged. You never know what the next person is going through. Like, I made a video. I always say this in some of my videos. Like, I moved to Dallas from my hometown, you know, by myself at a young age. Just getting out there and taking a leap of faith and moving to a city by myself and just trying to kind of change my life, you know, at a young age by myself. And do you know how many women and men in life is trying to do the same and don't know where to start? So I made a video just sharing my story so they can do exactly what I did and continue to level up and grow. So that's just what it is. Another question. What is a place that I always wanted to travel to? A place that I always wanted to travel to is Bali. Like, I want to go to Bali so bad. It's so freaking beautiful. And I just know, I feel it in my heart, I'm going to be able to go one day. I'm going to have the funds, everything set up to just fly out the country and just be on the beach and just enjoying the view and the vibes. And I want to be out there for like a damn near a week. Like, I want to be out there a whole week just relaxing. And just, when I go to Bali, baby, I'm going to have everything. I'm going to just be flourishing in life, okay? So, that's some. But that's a place that I always want to visit is Bali. Why did I create YouTube? That's a good question. I get that a lot. I created YouTube because I enjoy encouraging others. I was always that girl that everybody was just like, oh, she cool. I want to hang with her. Like, I love her vibe. I love her energy. I love her style. I love everything about her. It don't matter where I'm at, what city I'm in, who I meet. It's always people that's going to fall in love with the personality and my vibe. That's just how I am. I don't know why. They just do. And every time I, like, go out, I used to go out or just be out, people always just hit me up like, oh, I want to hang with you. Yada, yada, yada. Like, you just a whole vibe. Your energy is crazy. So, you know, I got into YouTube because I used to always, you know, just be on Snapchat. I used to be on YouTube. I'm always on YouTube, okay? But, like, I've been having a YouTube since, like, 2010. But I never posted on there because, you know, I don't know. One of the reasons why I never really posted on YouTube is because I always was worried about, like, what somebody will think of me or people judging me or whatever like that. But as I grew older and became, you know, got to know myself more, I'm just like, I don't care what people think. Like, this is me. You either gonna like it or love it. You either gonna love it or hate it, okay? So I just gained the confidence last year around January, and I was just like, you know, I'm gonna step out on the face, and I'm just gonna record my lifestyle, just record what I do. I'm gonna encourage women. I'm gonna encourage others. I'm just gonna just put people on to what I've been through, because you never know what people around the world that's going through similar stuff like you, when they watch your video and you just like encourage them to do like the most craziest thing, like move from another city. Because I can tell you, I don't care so many people to move from their hometown to a city like Dallas, and it's crazy. So, I mean, you just never know. And I enjoy just making others feel good about themselves. I love making women and just people just like feel good about themselves, like telling them like you can be confident in your own skin, thick, skinny, cute, short, dark, black, light skin, whatever the case may be confident and be you, okay? And a lot of times people be asking me advice on like friends and stuff like that. I just love to like give them the game on what I've been through and experienced in life. And I am young, but I done been through a lot too. So you just never know what others are going through, and they can come across your video just like I come across other people's videos on YouTube that inspire me and encourage me to go harder and do this, this, that, that. So that's why I started the YouTube, okay? Let's get into this next few questions, y'all. I don't want this video to be so long, so I'm trying to wrap it up. What are my hobbies? My hobbies are YouTube. No, I'm just saying. My hobbies, I love shopping. I love going to different places, trying new food. I love just dressing up, self-care, getting my nails done. Like, my hobbies are really simple. My main hobby is really just, you know, dressing up, going shopping, you know, doing things for me, self-love. I need to start saving more. I be spending a lot of money. That's the problem. That's why I'm trying to invest in all these incomes, because, baby, I like to spend. But, yeah, I definitely love shopping, you know, getting cute, going to have, like, dinner, drinks. I love just dressing up and just being a vibe, okay? That is my hobby. I'm not into sports. I'm not into none of that. I'm into, like, applying pressure. Nah, just laughing. I'm into just, like, girly stuff like makeup, shopping. I'm a foodie, you know, I love to eat. I'm a thick girl, so I'm into things like that. And another question, am I detail oriented or am I a bigger picture person? I feel like I'm a little bit in between, because I'm very detail oriented about the things that I want in life, the things that I do, and I'm also a bigger picture person too, because I'm just like, okay, this is, if you look at the bigger picture, like, this is what I'm trying to do. I'm looking at the bigger picture. So, I don't know. Maybe I am more of a bigger picture person, like, looking at the bigger picture of things. But I feel like I'm a little bit in between. My favorite color is orange. Like, a lot of people are like, what's your favorite color? It's orange, girl. I do wear a lot of black, but my favorite color is orange. I am an orangey, like, love orange. Orange and gray, baby. How did I grow my YouTube channel? What made me start? Okay, so they say, how did I grow my YouTube channel? Basically, if y'all want me to be honest with y'all, promoting myself on all my social media platforms, promoting myself in YouTube groups, but definitely promoting myself on my social medias. I just go so hard for myself on Instagram, TikTok, Snapchat. I do reels on Instagram, reels or whatever on Instagram. Promote myself on Facebook. I'm in different type of YouTube, Facebook groups. Like, I just promote every video that I am coming out with. And that's how I gain people into my channel. Like I said, we almost to 500. We're so close to being monetized, y'all. So I'm trying to get more consistent. This is the year of manifestation. And I said I'm going to be monetized before this year is up. I feel like, you know what? I'm going to be monetized within the next 3 months, 2 to 3 months. Hopefully it's sooner than that, okay? Like, that is the goal that I have set for myself. That's why I have to get on my ass and be like, you know what? I'm going to be more consistent. I have to be. You have to be. You have to be consistent with anything that you want to do in life, or it's not going to flourish as you want it to. So when you find yourself getting lazy or slacking off, falling off, you coming up with excuses, it's just you just pushing yourself back for from that goal that you're trying to reach, okay? So gotta be consistent. And I be telling myself all the time, like, Shantae, you trying to do this, you trying to do that, whatever, you need to take your, no. I need to be more consistent in all this shit that I'm trying to do so it can pop off. That's what it is, okay? So, yeah. Last question, I'm gonna go ahead and just wrap this up because, like I said, I don't want to talk y'all ears off. Am I single and why? I am definitely single and ready to mingle, okay? Where's my person? Nah, I ain't just playing. I'm definitely single and in my prime right now. I'm not really looking for a man. I'm just focused on me, myself. Like, I took the year of 2021 out to focus on myself, building myself up, getting myself where I need to be. That way I can already be ready and established for that right man, okay? Because the man that I want, woo, the man that I want, I want my man to be just established as I'm going to be. So, you know, I'm trying to just build myself up just for myself. And also, you know, when I do get to the top or where I want to be in life, I can date in that tax bracket that I want to date in. You know what I'm saying? Because right now, I'm just like, the men that like me is just like, you ain't ready. But nah, not only that, I'm just in my prime. I'm focusing on me. I'm doing me. I'm trying to get to where I need to be in life to prepare myself to be ready for that man. So when that right man do come into my life, he already got his shit together too. I got mine together too. We can just go ahead and build a foundation and build this team and go ahead and invest and open up different business. You know, I'm on some entrepreneur big boss shit. Like, that's where I see myself. I don't see myself working a 9-to-5 the rest of my life. And if you see yourself working a 9-to-5 the rest of your life, you seriously got a problem. Like, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with a 9-to-5, because my 9-to-5 is getting me to where I want to be, okay? So what I'm saying is, let your 9-to-5 get you to where you're trying to be. Let your 9-to-5 help you invest in stocks so you can be able to quit your 9-to-5, okay? Invest in anything. Just let your 9-to-5 be that stepping stone, that tool to get you to that next destination in life, okay? Because, I mean, maybe some people might love their career or their 9-to-5, but me, I'm speaking of myself. I'm not a 9-to-5 type of girl, so, like, I be really, like, confused on people at my job that be there for 30-plus years. Like, do what? Like, I'm trying to make what you made in this 30 years in a year type shit. Like, I want to go so far in life, and I feel it. Like, I'm so overwhelmed right now. Like, this is so off topic, but I'm so overwhelmed with just the things that I'm doing right now and the things that I want out of life. You know, my birthday's coming up, and I'm just like, baby, you got to sacrifice something. Do you really want to go on this birthday trip, or do you really want to launch this business? And sometimes you just got to sit down and be like, hey, this is more important. You know what I'm saying? But I am so overwhelmed because I have so many things going on right now in my life, including YouTube and stuff like that. And I'm just like, okay, you know, just be patient. It's all going to come together. So, no, I don't have time for a relationship right now. I don't have time to be distracted because I'm right about now, us women, we really taking over. I don't have time to be distracted. And I feel like a man that come into my life, he ain't gonna do nothing but help me go even harder and push me to my full potential, okay? That's the type of man that I wouldn't mind bringing into my life right now. But right now, I feel like a lot of people play a lot of games when it comes to dating, and I just don't have time for all that. Like, I'm trying to get somewhere. I would rather just be single and do what I need to do to establish myself. And then, once I'm established, be like, okay, you know, I'm ready to date. That's just me, okay? But anyway, thank you guys for tuning in to my channel. I hope this Q&A video helped you guys get to know me a little bit better. I will be back with more videos. Don't forget to like, give me a thumbs up, subscribe on this video, and leave me a comment, okay? Leave me a comment or two or three so we can talk. Let's connect. And tell me what you guys want to see next. I know a lot of people been telling me they want a video of Dallas. I got y'all. I got y'all. I keep saying I got y'all. I got y'all for real. Okay? Bye, love. See y'all soon.